Welcome to Portland's Providence Park, where this afternoon we gather to celebrate the 2023 graduating class of Benson Polytechnic High School. My name is Dr. Lorna Fast Buffalo Horse, and I'm the area senior director for Benson High School. It's my honor at this time to welcome to the stage Portland Public School Board member and vice chair, Mr. Gary Hollins. Dr. John Franco, chief of schools. Benson Tech High School principal, the one and only Curtis Wilson. Benson Tech High School Vice Principal, Ms. Sarah Calise. And Benson Tech High School Vice Principal, Mr. Barry Phillips. And now, the moment we are all waiting for, please join me in giving a great big Benson Tech welcome to the 2023 graduating class of Benson Tech High School. turn my ear. Oh.
Okay. Hello, family, friends, faculty, and graduates. My name is Hikma Edao, and I am your student body president. I would like to thank everyone for coming out tonight. We have an exciting ceremony ahead of us. I would like to welcome everyone to Benson Polytechnic High School's 106th graduating class. The class of 2023. It is my pleasure to introduce to you our principal, Mr. Curtis Wilson Jr., vice principal, Ms. Sarah Calise, and vice principal, Mr. Barry Phillips, and our 21 valedictorians, along with our distinguished guest tonight, board member Gary Hollins, and Chief of Schools, John Franco. At this time, I ask that everyone please rise and direct your attention to the flag for the national anthem and the Black National Anthem.
Stony the road we trod.
As your student body president, I would like to welcome you again on behalf of the class of 2023. To begin, I want to express my gratitude for all the teachers, administrators, parents, and my fellow students who have been there to support us throughout our high school experience. I would be remiss if I failed to acknowledge that without each of you, we would not be here today, given that in the middle of ninth grade, our lives were changed forever as we learned to navigate life in the midst of a pandemic. I think we can unanimously agree that this afforded us a truly unique high school experience. It would have been easy for us to quit, to have given up, but we did not. We persevered, and here we are. We are a reflection that disappointment is something most of us will experience in our lives. But how we choose to respond to that is what shapes us. We may lose hope, we may feel powerless, we may feel like life is working against us, but given our tenacity and ability to persevere, as we have these last 4 years, we can face these moments knowing we will get through. In the Holy Quran, it states, فَإِنَّ مَعَ الْأُسْرِ يُسْرًا إِنَّ مَعَ الْأُسْرِ يُسْرًا, which translates to, so surely with hardship comes ease. Surely with that hardship comes more ease. The second message I have for you all is to remember that while you may be your own harshest critic, you also have the choice to be your own biggest supporter. The power you hold and your confidence can be used to help you achieve great things. I recognize that at times you will fail and be disappointed in yourself, but that does not mean you can't learn and continue to grow, making every effort to do better next time. Confidence doesn't necessarily have to come directly from your heart. You can fake it till you make it. I promise you that just pretending you're confident in whatever it is that you're doing will make other people think you know what you're doing. Lastly, we must all remember to appreciate the lives we have and the opportunities before us. It is easy to get caught up in trying to accomplish all the goals we set for ourselves and miss the world going by all around us. If those early days of the pandemic taught us nothing, let us remember that it's okay to slow down. It is important to be grateful and that we shouldn't take for granted even the smallest things we have in our lives. So remember to have fun and enjoy life in the midst of all the craziness. Thank you, and I wish every single one of you the best of luck in whatever you plan to do next. Thank you.
Hello all, I am Ainsley Rayhawk, your senior class president and valedictorian. It is a pleasure to share this evening with all of you, but before I'm up, let's all give an awesome welcome to a wonderful principal who was our former Oregon Principal of the Year, Mr. Curtis Wilson Jr.
Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to the 106th commencement ceremony for Benson Polytechnic High School and the graduating class of 2023. My name is Curtis Wilson Jr. and I'm the principal of Benson Tech. And on behalf of my admin team, my staff, my teachers, to my community. I'm glad that you have taken this opportunity to come and celebrate this incredible achievement of our graduating senior class. As I think about what has transpired starting in the spring of 2020, I can't help but reminisce on the fact that those students over there that are now seniors, their freshman year was disrupted by what we now know as COVID-19. You, the seniors, you ended up spending your sophomore year doing online and virtual learning, and by your junior year, you were allowed back into the building, but with many, many restrictions. Some of you were not ready to return back to in-person learning and decided to continue with remote learning. But now that we've come full circle and it is your senior year, it is now, for me, time to reacclimate you back to student life, which was your last year in the building on the Marshall campus. And now that brings us to today, June 5th, 2023, where you will now be able to fully embrace your educational accomplishments in just a short time and begin a new chapter of your life. In regards to recognizing individuals, I would first like to recognize two Benson Tech staff members who will be retiring at the end of this year and have helped guide and nurture our students. Can you please help me in recognizing and thanking our math instructor, Ms. Susan Rose, and our esteemed librarian assistant, Ms. Irma Johnson. Can we give them a round of applause? I've known Ms. Johnson for many, many years, and I wish her and Susan Rose the best in their future endeavors. In just a short time, the 206 seniors that are sitting to my left will officially become graduates of Benson Polytechnic High School and will begin to take on the next chapter and challenge of their lives. To my seniors, whether you are moving on to that four-year institution, a two-year institution, you're going straight into the trades, or the military, or even straight into an apprenticeship, and for some of you, you're going straight to work. With that, I say, please pursue your passions with vigor and zest and let nothing hold you back. Set your own boundaries and continue to chase your dreams. Remember, you have survived a global pandemic, online and virtual learning, the move to a new campus for the last 2 years of high school, and have navigated these four unpredictable years of high school with resolve and resolution. The future is unknown, and I challenge you to think about how you can impact this world. Think about the sacrifices you have made to reach this accomplishment on this day. Look at yourselves and acknowledge that you are the future and the sky is the limit for what you hope to accomplish after high school. As you get ready to embark on that next journey, please remember to never forget to thank the individuals that have helped you reach this milestone. Whether it's your parents, your guardians, your siblings, your friends, your teachers, your counselors, the Benson Tech staff members that you see throughout the hallways over those last 4 years, or whomever. It's always important to recognize the individuals that have helped you complete this journey. And with that being said, graduates, I need you to do one thing for me. I'm going to ask you to stand up right now. Stand up, graduates. Look to your left, your other left. Look to your left, over here. And I need you to acknowledge all the individuals that have helped you reach this milestone. So can we give your parents, your guardians, your siblings, your friends all a round of applause for helping you reach this milestone? You did not do this alone. Okay, now you can be seated. As graduates and soon to be alumnus of Benson Tech, please note that you will always be welcome back with open arms to come and visit the school. And you know that in the fall of 2024, we'll be opening a brand new building on 12th Street. And I encourage you all to come and visit with us and check out the new building, as you will always be invited back as alumnus. My office door will always be open to our graduates, and it has been my utmost pleasure to serve as your principal during your tenure here at Benson Tech. I wish you all the best in your future endeavors. And finally, please remember to always keep our Benson Tech motto in mind, And I know some of you are thinking, what is our Benson Tech motto? Well, I can tell you right now, our Benson Tech motto is united by spirit and bonded by name. Never forget that. That will always keep us together from this point forward. So for the class of 2023, congratulations. Good luck to you. Godspeed and go Tech. Thank you.
I would like now to present to you guys a message from our superintendent, Guadalupe Guerrero, and our Board of Education.
Congratulations, class of 2023. My name is Guadalupe Guerrero, and as superintendent of the Portland Public Schools, it's my absolute privilege and honor to recognize this important milestone in your educational journey. I am proud of each of you and all that you have accomplished to get here today. Here to share congratulations are members of our school board.
I think the class of 2023 has shown their ability to be leaders and activists through their resilience.
I hope that this class never has to go through another global pandemic. I hope that for all of us.
They've shown us that they're prepared to fight back.
I really feel like our students, and particularly our seniors this year, have strengthened their voices.
They believe in who they are and what they're going to bring to the table.
I think that partly comes through a lot of struggle and just a lot of the difficulties of the pandemic.
We need the class of 2023 and other young people to be challenging the status quo.
The class of 23 has been front and center and loud and proud on things such as climate policy, transportation policy, labor issues.
It's scary to move on, and I certainly am scared to move on, especially since I feel like I've gotten so much like enjoyment out of being in high school, and I really did like it. But I think that this is just the beginning of what we're supposed to do, and after this year, we will have so much more freedom to make the changes and be a different person and to grow as a person.
That's really my greatest advice for our high school seniors is take those risks, believe in yourself, try crazy things, try things that are really out of your comfort zone.
My hope for them is for them to achieve whatever they want to achieve.
I wish that someone would have reminded me that the limitations that are set on me are only set on me by me.
I wish somebody had told me it was okay not to take a straight path to college graduation or to work or any of the other things that people expect of you, that it's okay to take detours, because those detours off the straight path are the things that enrich your life.
Take more chances. Live, explore, experience life.
I think my advice for the class of 2023 is to take your time. It is to find your path. It's to not rush into anything. You can, whether it's career, whether it's college, whether it's that first job, whether it's your next step, feel free to explore, feel free to try new things, and feel free to fail.
I hope that this class takes flight and really enjoys what's next, this next stage, whatever it may look like, that this stage of life brings opportunity and possibility and fulfillment for them.
Find the thing that really makes them joyful and happy. And it doesn't have to be what you do for full-time work, but do that, pursue that. Because lifelong learning is really a joy.
Congratulations to the class of 2023. You are inspiring. You give us hope. I'm so excited to see what you're going to be able to do in this world.
The class of 2023 is awesome.
I want to congratulate the class of 2023. You've made it. I know it hasn't been easy for some of you. Some of you have had a much harder path.
Congratulations to the class of 2023.
All right, class of 2023. Congratulations on an amazing 4 years. We did it.
Here's to your success, graduates. We look forward to hearing of all of your continued accomplishments. Once again, congratulations, class of 2023.
Thank you for the video, and additionally, thank you to Mr. Wilson for his tireless effort on the behalf of my class and all of Benson. Again, I am Ainsley Ray Hawk, your senior class president. Hello to class of 2023, and hello to all the family, friends, teachers, and staff that are here today. When I was preparing for this speech, I kept reminding myself that giving a speech isn't really that difficult. But standing here, walking the talk is always a little more intimidating. Speaking for a class so filled with diverse characters and interests is as scary as it is a privilege. So many friends and family are gathered here to celebrate our class, to celebrate the amazing feat it is that all of us made it here today. Being on this stage, it does feel like the whole world is watching. Watching us during these key transitional years as we prove ourselves to be the next generation of change makers. If there is anything that makes me proud and excited to be in Benson's class of 2023, it is that the students here walk that talk, even when it is intimidating. We are a class that gets it done, that puts action behind feelings and carves a path if one doesn't already exist. Pretending that the circumstances that got us here were normal is pointless. We were born into the age of information. The world has always changed rapidly around us. The pandemic, the autumn of fire evacuations in 2021, the new Benson campus, every year brought unfamiliar challenges. Each of us suffered and overcame unique and personal battles to become who we are today. From the beginning, our class was ready to show up for each other and to fight for our beliefs. Early in our freshman year, many of us turned out for the climate protests. We were all just 14 and 15, but even so young, we were passionate and filled with confidence and conviction. When quarantine interrupted our freshman year, many of us found connection and support through social media. I, like many others I know, left quarantine with more friends than I had started with. Which is not to say that it was easy. Our class watched many adults panic and didn't have the confident guidance we might have wanted during that time. We suffered through online school, watching as CTE teachers drew diagrams of electrical units, or as Mr. Frazier showed us simulations of how chemistry would have worked if we'd had any chemicals. Our teachers often tried to make the best of it, but it was a difficult and confusing time. Many of us lost loved ones. Despite the toll that the pandemic took on our world, our class resiliently found expression. We pursued creativity, we worked to explore self-identity, and we formed relationships. While it felt like the world was falling apart, we sought out love and meaning and continued to find hope and happiness in humanity. We carved that path towards healing. Our class learned to be the advocates we were missing. We show out for ourselves and we show out for our community. Many of us showed up for specific beliefs against social injustice and risked our health in the protests of 2020, and some of us here even helped to organize and lead those efforts. I am so proud to be part of this class who are so consciously and proudly ourselves. Being a student at Benson, we have helped each other learn invaluable lessons about ourselves and the value of community. This wasn't the default. We chose our schools. We chose our majors. Our class did not just end up here. We are here today because we recognize our passions and interests, and we are ready to take risks to pursue them. Our class has learned through action who we are. We've learned to love, to critique, and to not accept mistreatment, to not accept the way the world has always been. It is hard to say goodbye. Goodbye to our time together, our favorite teachers and lunch spots. Goodbye to our senior year. As we, the class of 2023, step into more responsibility and opportunity in society and explore our passions in new places with new people, I trust we will continue to seek to be true to ourselves and our values, and we will fight for the world we all deserve. So let's all say hello to our future. I have no doubts that we will change the world. Thank you for making me who I am today, and congratulations, class of 2023.
Good evening. My name is Sarah Calise, Vice Principal of Benson Polytechnic High School. It is my distinct honor and pleasure to introduce to you the valedictorians of Benson Polytechnic's High School Class of 2023. They are Benson's highest ranked seniors in the class, maintaining a 4.0 GPA throughout their high school careers. They will receive their diplomas first this evening. Valedictorians, please stand and be recognized as we read your name. Guests, direct your attention to the Jumbotron as we recognize these outstanding students. The valedictorians are Ariana Adams, Ethan Berger, Angel Castillo Bajorquez, Fran Didula, Desmond Gerber, Cole Hagedorn, Milan Hawk, Aisha Langer, Tun Lee, Samantha Lobdell, Cole McVeigh, Violet Myers, Samuel Peters, Bryce Powell, Ainsley Rayhawk, Devin Brownsville, Obi Salazar Rodas, Addy Stiles, Diamili Tuz Bajorquez, Cleo Zetos, Tabor Van Dusen, and Elliot Walker. Please give our valedictorians one big round of applause. Congratulations and thank you again to our valedictorians. This evening, I would like to recognize more of the outstanding students in our graduating class of 2023 and celebrate some of their accomplishments. I ask you to take a moment to look at the insert in your program. This insert lists scholarship and awards given to our students to date that we were made aware of. In summarizing these, we know that the graduates in the class of 2023 were awarded over $9,596,049 in scholarship money. These come from various sources, including public and private organizations and donors, as well as scholarships that are full rides or recurring tuition. A plethora of OSAC scholarships and grants were awarded to several deserving seniors, including the Simon Benson Memorial Scholarship, the Benson Alumni Scholarship, and the Oregon Promise Grant, to name just a few. Also, graduates received many additional monetary and achievement awards that are too numerous for me to announce here. Would all students receiving a scholarship or award please stand at this time? Thank you. You may be seated. As you may have noticed, graduates are wearing numerous cords and stoles. These signify completion of their course of study or involvement in a scholastic organization. The STOLs represent the various majors undertaken by our seniors and are the completion of the required courses necessary to receive their CTE endorsement and a Benson diploma. A number of students are also wearing honor cords this evening. Will all students with gold honor cords please stand? These students have completed their diploma with honors. Graduating with between a 3.0 and 4.0 cumulative GPA. Thank you, you may be seated. Will students with cords representing the National Honor Society please stand? These students have maintained a 3.5 GPA and have completed hours of community service as required by the National Honor Society. Thank you, you may be seated. Will our graduating AVID students please stand? These students have demonstrated unwavering commitment to attaining their academic and post-secondary goals. Each cord represents a year in rigorous AVID program and their commitment to community service. Thank you, you may be seated. Benson students also excel throughout the state and nation for their high-level technology skills. This year, Kayla Le, Jackie Mercado, Violet Myers, and Cleo Zetos received top honors at the state host of competition and qualified for the next level of competition. Kayla Le and Jackie Mercado will represent Benson at the HOSA International Competition in Texas later this June. Cleo Zetos and Violet Myers competed in the Internationals in Nashville last summer and placed in the top 36 teams in the world. We congratulate these students, along with the many others listed in the insert of your program, who are being recognized by colleges, universities, national and community organizations for their hard work and scholarship. Wow, we have reached the much anticipated point of the evening, the distribution of diplomas. So, without further delay, in accordance with the requirements set forth by the State of Oregon and Portland Public Schools Board of Education, I, along with the counseling staff, attest that the following graduates have completed in all requirements and are deserving of a high school diploma. Principal Wilson, I present to you the Benson Polytechnic High School graduating class of 2023.
Ariana Adams. Aisha Langer. Elliot Walker. Ainsley Rayhawk. Violet Valentine Myers. Diameli Tuez Bohorquez. Angel Castillo Bohorquez. Devin Roundsville. Samuel Kurt Peters. Desmond Gerber. Obi Salazar Rojas. Cole Hagedorn. Bryce Powell. Ethan Berger. Tabor Van Dusen. Cole McVeigh. Samantha Lobdell. Milan Hawk. Cleo Zetos. Congratulations. Addie Stiles. Frangelica Dadula. Kimmy Trin. Hikma Adawo. Biriam Mossy. Yusuf Demi. Moses Chesterfield. Hang on, Jerome, hang on. Jerome Duncan. Solomon Detger. Tatum Schaff. John Fernandez. Brandon Martinez Vasquez. Sylvie McCord. Uh-oh, this is going to be a hard one. Francis Curly O'Malley. Oh my God, how do I? Meg Reed. Maddie Grins. Elise Kennedy. Axel Beard. Ashton Jorgeris. I get that one right. Vincenzo Castaldo. Simmons. See, that's why we practice. Kevin Simmons. Ray Astor Black. Tanner Weber. Eliana Brown. Ludasia Watley. Priscilla Cote. Jacqueline Mercado. Rosalind Sanchez Alvarez. Kayla Lay. Oscar Abellane. Finn Sahara. Mateo Morgan. Samantha Cotton.
Congratulations, buddy.
Zach Underwood. Kainalu Shadley.
Dupree.
Sierra Dupuis. Tyler Decker. Tariq Dewan. Jeremy Wynn.
Oh, we got a cap down. Jeremy Falk. Falk.
Jeremy Falk. Levi Wendrow.
Golick.
Owen Golick. David Dent.
Sethan. Sethan Wendrow, right?
Sethan Wendrow.
Saul.
Saul Blackbird. Titan Bailey.
Thank you, Omar.
Omar Valencia Garza. Tony Casarasin.
Mm-hmm.
Benita Belleville. Mariana Valbuena. Brian Velez. Juan Zuniga. Keegan Hall. Phoenix Schuler Holbert.
Thank you.
Chaim Gerber. Indu Vogelfield.
Yeah. And the crowd goes wild. Graham Dolparella. Perfect. Thank you, Graham.
Graham Dolparella. Owen Robinson. Ruben Milhauser. Theodore Benson.
How do I say?
Redding Longacre. Owen Wiley. Gideon Lane. Dianara Hernandez. Dulce Maria Zurita Hernandez. Dylan Platt.
MJ.
Mary Jane Barber.
August Carlson.
August Carlson. Giovanna Fergiaro.
See, this is why we practiced a couple weeks ago.
Morgan Schlichten.
Kaylee Wester.
Kaylee Wester. Ariana Maya Ortiz.
What's up, buddy? Good to see you, buddy.
Oscar Batista.
Congratulations, Oscar.
Oscar Krimen.
You made it. Good to see you up here. Lilt Sahainen.
Lilt Sahainen.
Besa Watio.
Besa Watio.
Good to see you up here, man. Lampkin?
Jack Lampkin.
We made it. Congratulations. Jonah Lichten. Jonah.
Jonah Lichtenberg. Maxwell Shulman Peter.
Daisy, congratulations. Help me out on the last
Jesse's lot, Nick. Samuel Kuhn. Piper Doris Acton.
I like that.
Jacob Locke Dennis. Lauren Merrick. Finian Krause.
Congratulations, buddy.
Matthew Ocampo Garcia.
Perfect.
Linus Collins Schaefer. Tomas Excomparis. David Coot Interian. Alejandro Davila. Cindy Toos O'Shul. Giovanna Reyes Lorera. Rico Realize. William Belares. Jeremy Beza.
Stephanie, great to see you. Congratulations.
Stephanie Martinez de Jesus. Evelyn Larson. Rory Martos. Cesar Lindo Garcia.
We've made it.
Samuel Sanford Anderson.
Andrew Hoffman. Congratulations.
Andrew Hoffman. Yeah. Eliseo Starger Morena. Dooley Reardon.
Yep.
Henry Knapp. Yonatan Klatchko. Kieran Gabriel.
We practiced earlier.
Liam Gregston.
Phineas O'Hearn. Michael Tang.
Michael Tang.
TJ.
TJ Sackey.
And if I don't get that one right, I'm gonna have problems.
Fernando De La Torre.
I don't need no card.
Kayvon Bradford. Jalen Ann Johnson.
Congratulations. You want C?
Parker C. Myris.
Thank you, buddy.
Benicio Thorne.
Nantavarnet. That's why we practice.
Kieran Nantavarnet.
Oh, hang in there. You're done in 2 seconds.
Cecilia Stewart. Cyrus Rohrbaugh. Paco Guerrero. Eduardo Vasquez Rodriguez.
Ivan Manzo.
Ivan Manzo. Ivan Coleman. PJ Fisher.
Congratulations.
V. Holm.
Congratulations, Melody. Hang on to that hat.
Melody Bain. Sonia Vazquez Anigua. Adrian Castillo Interion.
Milo, congratulations.
Milo Hagedorn. Eris Lady Lopez Camacho. Shayla Alvarado. Gray Davila. Luke Spencer Underwood. Joey Wade.
Susie Jennings.
Susie Jennings. Mo Buckner.
Schramm. Thank you. Thank you, Porter.
Porter Schramm. Ian Alexander. Lucas Hosek. Andrew Hawes. Logan Oliverio. Joran Brand.
Hey, Jayshawn.
Jayshawn Tinnen. Kalina Rebhoff. Viene Apollonio Carrasco. Kalia Graham. Sanaa Panky.
And the crowd goes wild.
Marisha Martinez.
I got you.
Anaya Tutu.
Congratulations, Josh.
Joshua Reddy.
Chris Swanson. Thank you, Chris.
Chris Swanson. Isaac Magaro.
Isaiah, congratulations.
Isaiah Richter. Regina So. Jasmine Batres.
Maria.
Maria Maldonado Eusebio. Ana Luisa Miguel. Rachel Rector. Reba Monet Booz.
Thank you, Avery.
Avery Bjork. Carla Betsabe Chaka. Melissa Diaz Cadreno. Micah Campos. Nadia Hygienian. Tara Osborne.
Kaylee Reyes. Kylie. Thank you, Kylie.
Kylie Reyes.
Reese Bevin.
Reese Bevin.
Thank you, James.
James King.
Congratulations, you made it.
Arthur Hefty.
Eva Valdez. Valdez. Thank you, Eva.
Eva Valdez. Molly Brennan Bachman Steinberg.
Samuel, congratulations.
Samuel Berker.
Thank you.
Finn Logan.
Congratulations, team.
Aviana Frazier.
We're saving the best for last, huh? Congratulations, team.
Aaliyah Wilson.
Y'all ready for this?
Malaya Lasore.
Alex
Brazel.
Saving the best for last, huh? Congratulations, Devin.
Devin Key.
Thank you, and congratulations to the class of 2023. It is now my pleasure to present to you the senior class video presentation. We hope you all enjoy it.
Make sure I look hot, right?
Yep.
Okay.
Okay. Thank you.
We're gonna go interview some seniors. What do you think when you think future?
I think about college, but I more importantly think about a job and being successful in life.
That's right. I was talking about the rapper, but that's okay. Are you going to college?
Probably not. I'm probably gonna do a union for electrical.
How do you feel your experience at Benson Polytechnic High School has been?
As a community, we've been able to come back together for our senior year.
What advice would you give to your freshman year self?
Just be more outgoing. I mean, talk to people, start conversations, really enjoy high school.
Beautiful. This is America's next president, folks.
Thank you.
you have to say to these seniors?
Class of 23 is the best. I'm already missing them.
How would you describe the senior class in one word?
Oh, awesome.
What would you want your final words to be going out of here?
Finally? Work hard, play hard, and get your work done.
What advice would you give freshman year self?
What? Stop wearing leggings to school.
We're right here with the iconic Jacob Goop. What's your advice for the graduating class?
Follow your heart.
My name is Kimmy Trin, and I'm the executive coordinator of the student body. And thank you to the senior video students for helping us to celebrate our senior successes. Yay! To conclude our program, we shall now commence the tassel ceremony. I would like to invite our student body vice president, Violet Myers!
Graduates, please rise. Please raise your right hand and grab your tassel. On the count of three, we will move them from the right side to the left side. One, two, three. This motion symbolizes your official progression from high school. To everyone here today, we present to you the graduated class of 2023 of Benson Polytechnic High School.
Thank you all for coming today. Before we end the ceremony, I would like to share with you all one final quote from a movie that I used to watch with my godmother that inspires me to this day, Legally Blonde. You must always have faith in people, and most importantly, you must always have faith in yourself. Please head to the exits behind us through Gate B, as Ida B. Wells High School will be commencing their graduation directly after ours.